Hi, my name's John, and welcome to my review of Create Call Apps. Now, I've been a member of Create Call Apps since it very first launched. Created a lot of apps, become very familiar with the system as well. So I hope I can help you decide whether it's for you or not. Now, this review is going to be quite quick. I'm going to quickly show you some of the main features within the members area, and then we'll quickly talk about how to get it at the best price as well at the end. So, as you can see here, we're looking at my inside my members account, and the first thing you'll come across when you sign up is you're given loads of pre-templates to choose from. Now you can actually start your app from scratch if you like, but this is a great cool feature that's been added into this system, is where you can, if you've already got an idea for an app, there's loads of like great templates already set up for you to choose from. So for instance, the page you're looking at here, the one at the top here, we've got a car dealership. So if you want to create apps for car dealerships, then you could just select this and just edit a few images and stuff like that, and the click to call buttons or whatever you want to edit within that. But it just gives you, like I say, a really, really good start off point. And then you're like, if you're into celebrities and stuff like that, I mean, the main things you're going to be creating apps for and using Create Call Apps for is either to do apps for local businesses and charge them for the apps, or you're going to be doing like affiliate marketing apps and stuff like that, to basically make money from within your apps, from promoting products and stuff like that. There are other uses as well, but those are the main two that people tend to use them for. So as you've got, like I say, the celebrity one there, there's a Christmas app on here. This is really, really cool. It basically design little animated Christmas cards that can be sent out through the app. So really good to target at Christmas time, obviously. Then you've got coffee shop apps and stuff like that. Loads of cool ones to choose from. There's actually, as you can see, 17 pages to choose from down here. So once you decide what app you want to use, what template, whether it's a blank one or one of these, you just basically click on the select button, which we'll do here, and then you can decide if you want to look a bit more into the app before you choose that template, how you want to look at it. So you can select, if you want to look at an iPad view, it'll show you the iPad view, or an Android, and then you can actually select the device as well. So we go HTC, it just changes the way it looks. And this doesn't actually affect your app when you start building it. This is just for you, at the moment, your purposes of deciding whether you want to use the template we're looking at. So we'll go, yep, we'll use that template. So we'll go, or if you want to choose another, just go click on there. We'll use this template, just this quick demonstration here. Now the next thing you want to do is decide what you want to call it. So what we'll do here, we'll just leave it called that, but what you need to do, especially if you create a lot of apps, call it something you're going to remember and associate with that app, or it can start to get a bit confusing when you've got hundreds of apps in your account and you haven't named things properly. So don't call it app 1, app 2, app 3, because you'll end up not knowing which ones are which. It'll become a bit of a nightmare. So make sure you call it something that's associated with the app, so at least you know what it is. Excuse me. So we'll create it called Coffee Shop 11. Now once you're in this section, dead simple again, you just basically pick what you want it on, whether you want it on the any of these options here, so your iPhone, Android, Kindle. Now web app is basically it's an app that doesn't use any native features on the phones, because obviously iPhones created in iOS, and a Kindle device and Android is obviously Android programming language, which works differently. Your iPhone app wouldn't work on Android devices, but where if you create a web app, that'll work on all devices, but you do lose some of the native features. But I just want to mention that there. So let's have it selected, and we'll keep it on iPhone like that. Then you've got a little progress bar up here, but we're going to miss a lot of these sections out. I'm going to go next, because I don't want to take you through all that. You can go through these yourself, and maybe decide to sign up. So as we come on here, you create your little standard tabs. You can change the little icons at the bottom, or you can have it a spinning wheel, or you can have it with no tabs, where you just put all your options on the homepage. But like I said, we're going to miss all that out for now to save a bit of time to get to the juicy bits of the software. So we're just going to go done like that. So it's just going to just keep it as basic standard as it was. Here we go. This has loaded it now into the Create Call Apps platform, into your membership account, ready for editing. So the next thing we want to do to edit our app is dead simple. All we need to do is we click a little button up here that says convert the page type. That's if you actually wanted to convert this whole page here, or you can go into individual pages as well and just convert those as well. But this is like just for quick demonstration purposes. We'll go on here because I want to show you the features that you can use within Create Call Apps. So we're going to grid view, just to make things a bit clearer. Now this is the meat and potatoes of this app. It's going to show you just how phenomenal this app builder is. There's absolutely hundreds of features. It's so good. So I'm going to quickly run through them here. So These are your basic HTML pages. Now remember, as you're looking at these are all completely editable, but they're just provided for you to, you know, as a basis. If you already know you want a big image at the top and some text in the middle and there's an image at the bottom, then obviously it's going to speed things up for you. But once you select it, you can actually just, you can remove that image, change that text, and do anything you want, just delete everything, start again. But they're just your basics, like I say, to get you started a little bit quicker. Come in and or if you're stuck for ideas and for your page as well, it's a good little tip to come in here and have, oh, I like that one, you know, pick that and select that. So loads of different HTML pages, select from there, and then you've got your menu pages. Now these are generally the home page of your app. When people first load your app, these are generally the pages that will show. So you've got loads of different options to choose from, and again, like I said, you can change anything on here, the color, the images that are showing, you know, the picture up there, what that says, completely editable, but just again, basic designs. If you decide you like it, then just change the text to what you want it to say, or if you want to change the colors, like I say, just edit whatever you want. Just a quick way to get you started. So that's our basic template there. So if you was doing a pizza restaurant, you know, you could change these images of pizzas and put different pages and things in there to suit yourself, sort of thing. So these are all the different types of the main pages. You can see here, loads to choose from along there. Lots to choose from, loads of different designs to get you started. And then down here we have the HTML pages. HTML pages, so you got the about us, where you can put your about us information, like email address, telephone number. You can make them more clickable, like audio player, lots of cool stuff, like basic HTML calendars, countdown, a signature page, favorites page. Basically what that means, if you're building quite a large app with lots of different pages, the users can select their favorite pages and it'll appear on the special favorite page without having to search for the app each time for it. Basic forms there, charts, drag and drop, jQuery. This is a cool one. You can add a little password section to certain pages of the app, so password needs to be put in there. Push notification page to show push notifications that have come through, that you've sent through to the app. There's a poll. In-app purchases, you can add them as well. So if you're doing wanting to make money from within your app to unlock more content, then you can add those in there as well. Radio stream, there's a ratings page. There's so many to choose from. Shopping cart, phone gap, which is a whole new area of stuff you can add into there. It's a whole thing in itself, phone gap actually, which is way out of the scope of this video, but if you want to learn a bit about that, you can add just so much more things with that as well. And then you've got your native pages, which only work on the selective devices, so these won't work on your app, your web app, like I mentioned earlier. But you've got calculator, you've got calendar, Dropbox section, dictionary, email attachment sender, feedback, goal trackers, in-app browser. So basically it's a mobile optimized browser that will work within the app, optimized for the device that it's on, like a torch, here, lighter, login page, magazine page, instant messenger, order page, another product order page, a document scanner, a music player, scoreboard, slot machine game, NMS, SMS, messaging, video list, voice recorder. There's so many things. It goes on and on and on and on and on. Then you've got your geo pages, so GPS directions. You can put images and pages behind these little icons, directions to them and stuff like that. Click for direction to get directions to a local business or whatever. And then you've got image galleries, different types of images and the way they're shown, 3D images and 3D layer design. There's actually, you know, sketch image designs as well. They can design their own images from within the app. There's just so many cool, such cool features. The 360 one here, which is great for things like property apps and stuff like that, where people can actually do a 360 view of the house that they're interested in. Phenomenal. Vertical slider. Then you've got this here, you can actually image editor within the app as well. Some of these are just apps within themselves. You could actually just put one of these in and create the app just over that one thing. And then you've got your social parts of the app, so all your social networks within the app as well, with all the updates and things like that. Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, RSS feed. This is great for news, the latest news. Your app will automatically update through its internet connection with all latest content and news about your selected topics and things like that. Just amazing. It's just absolutely phenomenal what you can do. GPS coupons and QR code scanner. This is great as well. This basically unlocks, you select the GPS location, and then with the distance you want this to be unlocked for. So say you want something to the coupon to unlock a mile away from a local business that's doing an offer, then when the phone reads it's within a mile from that location you're putting, the coupon will unlock and be able to use it. You've got a loyalty thing here where they get stamps for visiting the whatever it is they're doing, and there's a pass, it's a password protected, so they basically pass their phone to the local business and the local business will put their password in, and a little stamp will appear here, and they can choose as many as they want stamps to appear, how many they need to get whatever it is they're offering. Just so many cool little things you can do. And here you have a PDF reader. Different types of PDF readers as well, so you can read PDFs from within the app, both for Android and iOS as well. And there's games as in here as well, like karaoke. Absolutely phenomenal. The choice of this app is just absolutely amazing. You're only really limited by your own imagination. And once you're in here, there's full training given how to do all this stuff. And once you've learned, it's pretty simple really, just a matter of clicking on there and adding it to your app, and then editing it as you wish, and with your own content and what you want to put on there. It doesn't take very long. You can knock out. You can a few apps a day if you wanted, or even more than that. Depends, how detailed you want to go into your app building and stuff like that, and how big you want to make your app, and what you want to put on there. But it's absolutely brilliant. I've been using app builders pretty much since they first started coming out. I've tried a lot of different types and variations, and this is the only one I've stuck with because it's just, in my opinion, by far the best, and it's actually the cheapest as well, which is an amazing feat really. That it's so good, and it's actually the cheapest one out there. It's a lot better than the more expensive ones that I've tried as well. So it's for me, it's a no-brainer anyway. Now, at the time of recording this video, the price for Create Call Apps is $19.95 dollars a month. Now, that's for unlimited apps. You can create as many apps as you want. There's no cap on there. You can send unlimited push notifications out through your apps. So that's a really, really fantastic price. And also, again, it's only at the time of this video. I'm not sure if this offer will still be on by the time you guys come to click the link under the video to check it out. But like I said, at the time of the video, they're doing an offer. If you introduce somebody and one of your friends or whoever it is to Create Call Apps, and they sign up for account as well, you actually get $10 off your monthly fee. So basically, it only costs you $9.95 a month, which is just mind blowing, really, for what you're getting here. Absolutely phenomenal. But like I say, that's on the sales page. Like I say, if you click the link below the video, you'll find information about that towards the bottom of that page. And all you need to do to claim that is just contact support. If you've got someone to sign up, tell them who it is after they've signed up, and then they'll arrange a discount from there. Now, like I say, I don't know if the offer will still be on by the time you come from this video. Hopefully it is, and they've been running for quite a while now, so I don't see why not. So yeah, that's about it guys. So like I say, click the link under the video if you're interested to learn a little bit more, if you want to purchase it today. And I hope I've helped you make a decision whether it's for you or not. And if you do decide to buy it, I wish you all the best in creating your apps. I know you'll be able to create some amazing apps like I've been able to do, and it's really a joy to use. So thanks again, and I'll speak to you soon. Take care, bye bye.